Hey guys, welcome back. I'm actually really excited about today's video because I'm gonna show you how I diagnose somebody's organizing style just by snooping around their house. I can walk into anyone's house and in within minutes know their organizing style, and I'm gonna show you all the little spaces I look to find that out. Your organizing style is basically a combination of how you sort and how you store your things. And so I'm not looking at your mess. I'm not looking at what isn't working. I'm looking at what is working. So I always choose high traffic areas, things that you touch every single day, like the kitchen. If I walk into your kitchen and I see that all of your appliances are on the counter, if I see that, you know, your spatula that you use is in a bucket right on the counter, if the front of your fridge is covered in stuff, magnets and coupons and photos and notes, you're a visual organizer. This is used to be the one place that I could always look and always know, but a lot of people now have stainless steel fridges, which don't hold a magnet. My point is that used to be my telltale sign was the front of the fridge. So if you have a stainless steel fridge and you're a visual organizer, you usually have a bulletin board or a pile of papers. And that's how I can really determine, right, just looking in your kitchen, if you're visual or not. Another space I love to snoop is in your bathroom. If your bathroom counter has every bathroom product you use in the morning on the counter, you're probably a visual organizer, or if it's hidden away, you're probably a hidden organizer. I also like to snoop in entranceways. If you're kicking your shoes into a corner instead of putting them in a closet, or if your coats are like on knobs or just everywhere instead of in the closet, you're a visual organizer. It's really important to know if you're visual or you're hidden, because the truth is, this is about anxiety. If you're a visual organizer, you feel anxious when your things are out of sight. For you, it's out of sight, out of mind, and subconsciously, you think you're gonna forget about things, which is why you like things out in the open. But for a hidden organizer, it causes anxiety to see all the stuff, which is why they're hiding it and putting it behind closed doors. Sometimes it can be really difficult to know if you're a visual or hidden organizer because you may have too much stuff. So there's a lot of things everywhere because there isn't spots to put things away, or you could be still using something, or you're not done with it, or you haven't had time to put it away yet, and so you're leaving it out. That's why it's really important to look at the spaces in your home that are working, things that you are using every single day. When you're done with it, are you putting it out of sight? Or are you putting it back in a visual way? But also know that this is a scale, okay? If you were to look at my bathroom right now, there is stuff all over my bathroom counter. That does not mean that I'm a visual organizer, because the majority of my spaces are hidden. You may have a couple of spots where you prefer visual organization, but most of your stuff is hidden. You're a hidden organizer then. So that takes care of how you store things. I can tell, I've already determined if you're visual or not. Now I have to determine how you sort things. And this is where I get really snoopy. I peek in your drawers. Are they a hot mess sandwich? Is everything a jumbled mess, or is it pretty neat and tidy? I peek inside closets to see, are you folding your towels? Are things, you know, do they have categories? Or is it a hot mess? Another really surprising place that I check is your toothpaste tube. I can tell a lot about a person by their toothpaste. So detailed people generally will take the time to use a toothpaste tube and put the lid on. And then there's us, non-detailed people. This is my toothpaste tube. I'm a ladybug. This is Joe, he's a cricket. What? Is he even human? So I do. I peek at people's toothpaste tubes to see if they're detailed or non-detailed people. I also love to look at vacuum cords. I don't wind vacuum. I toss the vacuum cord at the vacuum, but if you take the time to neatly wind it or neatly wind your hose, you're probably a detailed person. So this is what I'm looking for when I'm trying to determine how you naturally sort. Do you take the time to put something away properly in a detailed way? Or do you need to be able to toss it without thinking because your brain has already moved on? So it's this combination of how you sort and how you store that make up your organizing style. Are you a visual organizer, or do you prefer hidden storage? Are you a really detailed sorter, or do you prefer fast, easy, simple, broader categories when it comes to how you sort your things? It's that combination, whether you're visual or hidden, and whether you're detailed or not detailed, that make up your organizing style. I want you to remember that this is not your fantasy self. Everyone wants to be a detailed person. I don't want my toothpaste tube to look like that. In an ideal world, I put everything away properly, but that isn't how I actually live my life on a daily basis. And organizing isn't about fantasy. It isn't putting rainbow things in colors. It isn't having things look Pinterest worthy. It's how you function. That's why it's so important to know how you naturally organize your stuff so that you can set up a system that catches it the way you naturally do it, which makes it effortless to stay tidy. That's what organization is really about. It's having a home for everything and having everything easily go back in its home. So you may think, okay, my house looks pretty visual, but I don't want to look at clutter. Being a visual organizer doesn't mean you like clutter. Nobody likes clutter. It means your everyday things, 9 times out of 10, you're gonna leave it out anyways. So why not make its home out and visual? It can still be beautiful. It doesn't have to look like clutter, but you need to work with how you are naturally managing your stuff anyways. If you want to learn more about your organizing style, I call them clutter bugs. There's like 4 cute little bugs. It's a whole thing. I'm going to put a link below to a free ebook that goes into details about all of the different styles, how you can combine the styles with a different type. I updated this ebook, so if you've already checked it out, check it out again. It's new, lots of new content in that. I'm going to put the link below. You can also take the free quiz on my website, clutterbug.com. Do me a favor, in the comments, let me know if you take the time to wrap up your garden hose or your vacuum cleaner cord, or if you're like me and you just like leave it in a pile on the floor. I'm genuinely curious. Hey guys, thanks so much for those of you who have stayed to the end. I wanted to do a quick story about my bearded dragon, Daenerys Targaryen. My mother-in-law was actually watching her while we were gone the whole time. She was terrified, and yet she bathed her every day and fed her and took really probably better care than I've ever taken care of her in my life. But yeah, terrifying, right? She's terrifying. When we first got her, Abby begged for a bearded dragon for like a year, and I shrieked anytime she moved. I was so scared, and now we're besties. We are besties, and she loves to cuddle. She's slightly aggressive right now because while we were gone, it was her first time ever laying eggs. Ah, she's like a mother, except they don't hatch. It's like a chicken, it's weird. But anyways, she gets really aggressive before she lays the eggs. That's apparently how you can tell she's about to lay again. Let's see if she's so sweet. But after she laid the eggs, my mother-in-law called. She was like so excited about it. And then on the phone, she went, she's eating them though. She's eating them. So I don't know how motherly instincts bearded dragons have. After they take the time to make the nest, lay the eggs, cover it with sand, the next day they go back and they eat their young. Sometimes I can relate, Danny. You know what I'm saying? Well, she's asleep. Anyways, I just wanted to share about my bearded dragon because yes, they're terrifying at first, but once you get to know them, they're just basically adorable, hairless, spiky cats. If you're looking for a really easy, amazing pet, a bearded dragon is definitely a contender. Isn't it cute?